it's another Armfro's battle versus Andy of Abra's Assailant. This is a very huge mind battle versus a trainer versus trainer. So here we go. He sends out his scout. And so I sent out my Gary 09. I switch out to my Poop. I go, I know he would go for Earthquake just to be able to take out my guy, even if my guy was Focus Sash and wouldn't do much against his scout. So he switches out to his Dusknoir's Elite Seed. And because I actually do that, I'm actually able to go back to full health, which is pretty awesome. So I go for a Seed Flare just to figure out, even if he does Will-O-Wisp, I'm not going to do shit because I have Natural Cure. And the burn will just wear off after I switch. Even Leech Seed won't do that much. So, I just go for a Seed Flare, and he switches into his Porygon 2, his floating duck thingy. And my Poo Seed Flares it, and it does a little less than half. And after Leftovers, I just know that he's going to go for something here, go for a cover. And I thought he would be fearing a close combat, so I just go for a Substitute. But he goes for HP Ground, which is very surprising. Maybe he thought his Porygon 2 would be able to take in close combat. But my Gary isn't that type of Infernape. So I go for my Horny. He sees the duck, and I don't know why, but Horny likes ducks. But the duck runs away, and it goes to his ghost thingy. And the close combat doesn't hit because it's a ghost. Stupid ghost. And I switch out to my Gary. Just to take the Will-O-Wisp. And, I just go for a Substitute, predicting a Switch or a Will-O-Wisp again, and he goes for a Nightshade. And so, I just go for an Overheat, just do as much damage as I can against this guy, but he lives. That shows how bulky Dusknoirs are. They're just ridiculous, and he actually Earthquakes me as super effective, so my Gary goes down. So, I just go into my Black Chrome here. Everything's nice with Black Chrome. I mean, look at it, it's so pretty. And I just go for Meteor Mash to take it out, and I'm actually able to kill it. So he goes into his scout again. I know I predict a U-turn, and I just go for a Meteor Mash, and I hit a Captain. Captain. Because of the head thingy. Anyways, I didn't get the attack increase for both of them, which is really stupid. But I just go, so I just switch out into my Puffs, predicting an Earthquake. So I predicted right, and I just might as well go for a Dragon Pulse. And this guy takes it. Oh my god, he takes it so freaking well. It goes for an Avalanche. It almost kills my Puff, which is not good. So I just go for a cover here. I know he can't kill me with an Avalanche because I'm not hitting it, and Avalanche doubles when I hit it. So he goes for a Waterfall, predicting a Switch, and it doesn't do jack. And so I just go for a recover again, as he goes for an Avalanche. And it's not going to do nearly as much damage, but I actually heal more with each recover, so I just go for a recover again. And he gets pissed off, and he roars at me. And I just get so scared, and Puff runs away. He goes for a Black Hunt, which is not a good matchup, and I know he would predict a Switch, and so I just go for an Earthquake. An Earthquake. It does decent damage, and I know I'm actually able to 3-hit KO it. So that's what I do. I actually go for another Earthquake. I go for another Earthquake, and he goes for Earthquake and actually takes me down to red, which is not good. I mean, so I know I'm faster. I know he's gonna either switch out or stay in and die. So I just might as well just go out in a big boom. And so I use Explosion here, and he actually switches out into his Flygon, his Scout. And I explode in its face, and it dies in a big fiery flame of fire. Haha. So I go into my Horny, my big pink bug that's Horny. He goes to his Annoying, and I guess Horny doesn't like annoying stuff, so he misses. And so he hits the sub as he goes for a Seismic Toss. And that Seismic Toss is going to bring me down to 109 health. And so, I decide to go for another Mega Horn here, and he switches out into his Captain, which is actually able to KO it, which is pretty nice. So, he goes into his Porygon 2. I don't know why I switched here into my Poo. It's not really a smart move, because he goes for Ice Beam, and actually takes me down to a little lower than half health after Leftovers. So, this frickin' duck thing, I switch out to my Arcanine to take the Ice Beam. And I actually go for a Will-O-Wisp. This Will-O-Wisp is gonna miss, but he switches out into his Queendra. Because of the girl. So, I'm actually able to Will-O-Wisp as he switches out again into his Porygon 2, just to get the, to trace the Intimidate. I'm scaring that I'm a physical, but I'm not a physical, I'm actually a special. So I switch out to my Puff, and actually, as he does Hidden Power Ground, I just go for a Dragon Pulse and see how much damage I can do, and I know his Ice Beam isn't going to kill my Puff. So, his Ice Beam is actually able to take me down to lower yellows. As he gets hurt by burn, I know I'm actually able to kill it with another Dragon Pulse. So his freaking floating duck thing goes bye-bye. And I didn't know annoying things were so fast, but I'm actually able to HP Fire just to take out a sub. And I know now that if I did stay in, he could seismic toss me and KO me. So I just go for my Arcanine, and as he goes for a Protect, just to heal some health off. I actually go for a Fire Blast here, just to, we did this epic stall war here, that's why this freaking video is so freaking long. So he just subs and I Fire Blast, sub, Fire Blast, sub, Fire Blast. And after I thought he would switch out, after this sub, I thought he would switch here, but he doesn't. He goes for a Will-O-Wisp. I go for a Will-O-Wisp and he subs, which is stupid. It was a stupid decision on my part, as he leads seed, so he's actually able to heal enough health just to make another sub, which is annoying. And I didn't want to get subbed. My Arcanine, my Fluffy Puppy, doesn't want to get subbed. So I actually switch out here. I switch out to my Pooh. And he goes, as he goes for another sub. Pooh can take a seismic toss and he can't get lead seed, which is very good advantage over this annoying frickin' thing. A gecko? It looks like a gecko. Anyways, I go for HP Ice just to take out his substitute. And as he goes for, as he heals back up to yellow, I know I'm actually able to take another seismic toss because I'm 118. He switches out into his Queendra. And it gives him a girl. Anyways, he takes the HP Ice pretty nicely because it's neutral damage. And so I decide to go for a Seed Flare. And it misses. Holy crap. So, he Dragon Dances up, so I might as well, I'll just go for another Seed Flare to see what he does. He goes Dragon Dance, and I hit, which is pretty nice. And it does epic damage against his Queendra, so another Seed Flare would have killed, but lose some, win some, whatever. Anyways, he goes for a Draco Meteor, and so now I'm actually predicting what type of set this is. Waterfall Outrage, Draco Meteor, and Dragon Dance. So I switch to my Fluffy Puppy, my Arcanine, as I get Intimidated off, just to negate one Dragon Dance. And after, Super Effective, Life Orb, one Dragon Dance off, and I'm actually able to kill my Fluffy Puppy, which isn't very nice. So Horny just wants to take revenge. He does the Dragon Dance up as he misclicks, and I just go for Mega Horn, and I date rape this Queendra. Take the penetration. Anyways, it's girl-on-girl action, guy-on-girl action again. So as I Mega Horn is annoying freaking thing, so it's a good battle, Andy. Rate, comment, and subscribe. Stay classy, guys.